We meet together in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. We gather on this All Saints Sunday as the people of God to worship Almighty God. And so first let us call to mind and confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those inexpressible joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever. Amen. We now listen to our words from Holy Scripture.
The first reading is a reading from the book of Revelation. After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshipped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honour and power and might be to our God for ever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one who knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple, and the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the thrones will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." This is the word of the Lord. The second reading is a reading from the first letter of John. "See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and this is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, he will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all those who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure." This is the word of the Lord.
saints who from their labors rest, who thee by faith before the world confess thy name, O Jesus, be forever blessed. Alleluia, Alleluia. Thou wast their rock, their fortress and their might. Thou, Lord, their captain in the well-fought fight. Thou in the darkness still their one true light. Alleluia, Alleluia. Oh, may thy soldiers, faithful, true, and bold, fight as the saints who nobly fought of old, and win with them the victor's crown of gold. Alleluia, Alleluia. Oh, blessed communion, fellowship divine, we feebly struggle, they in glory shine. Yet all are one in thee, for all are thine. Alleluia, Alleluia. From earth's wide bounds, from ocean's farthest coast, through gates of pearl streams in the countless host, singing to Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Pray that I may speak in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Today, as we celebrate All Saints, our minds perhaps turn to the images we have of saints in our churches, perhaps in stained glass or a statue standing on a pedestal. This year has been quite a year, both for putting people on pedestals and also for pulling them down from them. Of course, we even have our own saint here in Bosham, Dykel, and the Dictionary of Christian Saints says of him, Irish Abbot of Bosham, this devout but uninfluential abbot with 5 or 6 monks was found by Wilfrid when he evangelised Sussex in 681. Nothing is known of him, but his name occurs in a few ancient martyrologies. History has not stuck him on a pedestal, but as we all know, a pedestal is often a precarious place to be. Near the beginning of the pandemic, we had the clap for carers, those people who became seen as heroes for keeping our country going and keeping us all safe. It is good that their vital work did not go unnoticed. However, we must remember that we can be fickle though, and it is so easy to forget or begin to despise people when we are reminded that they are human just like us. Then there are those statues that have been pulled down, or that people would have liked to pull down in some of the protests earlier in the year following the killing of George Floyd. These were people who have been seen as outstanding or perhaps as heroes, but whose humanity also encompassed attitudes that are no longer seen as desirable. The problem with putting people on pedestals and with pulling them down is that in both ways we can miss the reality that human beings are a complex mixture of good and bad traits. Positive attitudes and actions can live alongside human weakness, and with the failure at times to live up to our own ideals. If the imperfect were rejected, then who would be left standing? The problem with erasing our history is that we lose something vital from our human story, since we learn both from heroic action and also mistakes and wrongdoing. On the other hand, if we make people out to be heroes and angels, we can easily forget that they are made from the same stuff as the rest of us. And so it is with the saints that we commemorate today. They are not all alike, but are a very mixed bunch of people. One of my favourite saints, St. Peter, was full of eagerness, but often seemed to put too much faith in his own human strength. And then St. Paul had a great zeal and energy, but he came from a history of persecuting the first followers of Christ. And then there was Augustine, that great theologian, who as a young man prayed for chastity, but not yet. These are just a few of the better known examples of saintliness coexisting with human imperfection. Importantly, none of those imperfections prevented the love of Christ shining through their lives, both during their time on earth and indeed down the ages. So where does that saintliness come from that we venerate today? I think we find the key in the words of Jesus as he spoke to the disciples on the hillside. He speaks of poverty of spirit, gentleness, mourning, hungering and thirsting, mercy, purity, peacemaking, and even the state of being persecuted. All of these run counter to the narrative of our world, which despises weakness and human need, and instead chooses status and power. Saints Peter, Paul, and Augustine, and countless others did not become saints by trusting too eagerly in their own human qualities. The vital difference was that they came to see that they were nothing without God. It was from that point onwards that the power of God could work through their human strengths and indeed weaknesses to do something great. Did St. Paul not write in the letter to the Corinthians, "For when I am weak, then I am strong. So what about each of us? We might feel that our own story pales into insignificance beside such a great multitude of saints. So it is worth remembering, though, that St. Paul himself addressed his letters to the saints, these being ordinary Christians who were still alive, probably being faithful, but at the same time making mistakes and experiencing doubts as well. The call to holiness, to sainthood, in fact, is something for all of us. We might feel it is unrealistic, but only if we doubt what God can do. The first letter of John reminds us, think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. He goes on to say, my dear people, we are already the children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him because we shall see him as he really is. Like God. Just consider how amazing that is for frail and fallible human beings. And in the first letter of Peter we read, instead, as he who called you is holy, be holy yourselves in all your conduct, for it is written, you shall be holy, for I am holy. We cannot then avoid the call to holiness in this life. Today, as we remember all saints, we are also remembering in prayer those who have gone before us, our loved ones who are in the nearer presence of God. The book of Revelation uncovers the hidden reality that the Holy Spirit is revealed through faith. Who are those people in white robes assembled around the throne of grace? I think I know the answer to that, and so do you. They are not only the saints we commemorate today, but also countless others who have gone before us, and potentially you and me. Imagine that. This puts the spotlight of All Saints' Day back on us. The saints we celebrate today allowed the power of God to shine through their human strengths and weaknesses. So then how can we do the same? Well, Pope Francis wrote these words. To be holy ones does not require being a bishop, a priest, or religious. We are frequently tempted to think that holiness is only for those who can withdraw from ordinary affairs to spend much time in prayer. That is not the case. We are all called to be holy by living our lives with love and by bearing witness in everything we do, wherever we find ourselves. Are you called to the consecrated life? Be holy by living out your commitment with joy. Are you married? Be holy by loving and caring for your husband or wife as Christ does for the church. Do you work for a living? Be holy by labouring with integrity and skill in the service of your brothers and sisters. Are you a parent or grandparent? Be holy by patiently teaching the little ones how to follow Jesus. Are you in a position of authority? Be holy by working for the common good and renouncing personal gain. So then, my brothers and sisters, as we celebrate All Saints, and we also remember All Souls, let us pray for the power of the Holy Spirit, that it may work in us as we give thanks for God's grace, which he pours lavishly upon each of us, and indeed those who have gone before us. Amen.
Let us pray to God, whose saints have witnessed his glory. Everlasting God, we pray that your church, built on the foundation of the saints, will be faithful to the teaching of Christ so that it reflects his likeness. Lord and Father, as you kindled the flame of your love in the hearts of the saints, give to us the same faith and power of love, that we may benefit from their unselfish examples. Lord, in your mercy. Hear our prayer. Father God, as we continue to live through the coronavirus pandemic, we pray for those who represent us in government, both here in England, across the UK and throughout the world, and the professionals from whom they seek advice. May they act with integrity and compassion as we enter another phase of uncertainty. Help us all to be responsible in the things that we do in our lives to prevent the spread of the virus by taking heed of the recommended precautions and avoiding situations which may make things worse. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. May we not so much seek to be consoled as to console, not so much to be understood as to understand, not so much to be loved as to love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. This day, Creator God, may our eyes be opened to see the beauty in all that is ordinary, yet special, around us. May the glory of all that you have made remind us of your presence and lead us closer to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Risen and reigning Lord, whose touch alone could heal the sick, hear our prayers for those who are ill as we ask for your help and mercy to restore them to health. May your love be the key that releases us from suffering and fear. We especially pray for Rodney, Sheila, Luca, Lance, Ruth, Jeremy, James, Geraldine, Christine Graves, Joe Scholes, Tracy, Jennifer, John. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Merciful God, give us the grace to follow in the footsteps of the saints as they followed in the footsteps of your Holy Son. Keep alive in us the memory of those dear to ourselves whom you have called to yourself, and grant that every remembrance which turns our hearts from things seen to things unseen may lead us always upwards to you until we come to our eternal rest. We pray especially for those whose anniversaries fall at this time. Judy Belinda Pedgrift, Jane Lake, Brian Bowley. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Faithful God, we thank you for the example of all the saints. Help us to follow in their footsteps with courage and hope, determined like them to do your work and live the gospel of your Son. And finally, in the words of Mother Teresa, not all of us can do great things, but we can do small things with great love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
We are fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God through Christ our Lord, who came to preach peace to those who were far off and those who were near. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us now sing our offertory hymn.
Couch was wet with tears. The with sins and doubts and fears. We ask them whence their victory came, they with united breath ascribe their conquest to the Lamb, their triumph to his death. They mark the footsteps that he trod, his zeal inspired their breast, and following then cometh God, possess the promised rest.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise for your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit he took flesh, and as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us, and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, the Apostles and all the blessed saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. And so let us pray with confidence, as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Body of Christ. Amen. Blood of Christ. Amen. Let us pray. God, the source of all holiness and giver of all good things, may we who have shared at this table as strangers and pilgrims here on earth be welcomed with all your saints to the heavenly feast on the day of your kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Just before the final blessing, can I say how wonderful it is that you have joined us online for our worship this morning. It's lovely to have you with us. And just to highlight a few of the notices in the pew sheet, can I bring those to your attention? Especially the one concerning next Sunday, which will be Remembrance Sunday. There is an 8 o'clock service and then a 10:30 service, during which we will have our act of remembrance. So if you are planning to be with us in person, as it were, in church, then please make sure that you book your place in order to join us at the 10:30 service next Sunday. And also there are notes about Bible studies and also our Zoom church, which you can join us on a Sunday evening at 7:45 when we come together via Zoom to worship Almighty God. Well, I hope that you all have a fantastic week, and let us pray for God's blessing upon us. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.